Hey guys, do you know how to create reflection and glass effect? Maybe you have already tried and the result was not good. But if this have already happened to you, don't you worry because we're going to solve this problem. Today we are going to go through how to draw a crystal ball realistic. Very simple and easy for beginners. We'll start off by creating a graphite layer onto the paper. Try to create linear motions going from one side and moving straight over to the other side of the paper. If you already have any toned paper, you can skip these steps. You can go directly to the part of the video that we start to sketch out. Another important thing is to get a smooth result, a smooth layer, try to hold the pencil further back. If you ease off putting pressure on the pencil, it's going to be easier to mix the graphite using the paper, the tissue, or even the blending stump afterwards. Doing this, we prevent from having any stubborn darker lines showing through. Once we've created the first layers, we can create some more darker layers on top of it. Now let's move on for blending the graphite. You can use a tissue for this, and that's what I recommend you to use, because when it comes to blend large areas of the paper, it's much more easy to get a smooth result by using the tissue instead of the blending stump. We use more blending stump for small areas or for blending tiny details. It gets smoother and more uniform when you go in circular motions. Now using the pen eraser, I'm going to fix all the messy details, the darker details that got no shading. For doing this, you don't need to press hard. The only problem here is that our paper went dirty and we are just cleaning it. Now for this step, we are going to create a circle. You can use a round object to help you in this process. Perfect. Until by the end of this video, we are going to make our drawing look like this. But before, if you want to learn how to draw like me, create graphite drawings or colored pencil drawings, I can teach you everything you need to know on my online course. It's open for enrollment, and I'm giving support for all the students because with my constant feedback, the students improve their drawings much more faster. So if you click on the first link of the description and see that it is still open, it's going to be a real pleasure for me to teach you everything you need to know about colored pencil drawings and graphite pencil drawings. You will learn how to draw nose, eyes, how to create skin textures, hair, and much more. You'll really learn how to draw whatever you want realistically. So click on the first link of the description and become the artist that you want to be. Now coming back to our drawing, let's start off by creating the darker parts of the crystal ball. With the 4B pencil, let's create something similar to a half moon, in a dark detail on that same side. After doing this, let's create a transition between that dark part going to the lightest part of the crystal. You just need to adjust the pressure of the pencil to create a really smooth transition. And to mix it even more, we use a blending stump. Now with the same 4B pencil, let's dark this area that we've just created first. For this, I'm not pressing hard the pencil, and I'm using the side of the pencil to make the creation of that layer easier. Once we've done it, we create a transition between that area going to the lightest area on the right side. Let's sketch out another detail on the other side. And fill this detail. To give more contrast, let's apply another layer on the left. But don't forget to consider the transition from the darkest part over to the lightest part. And let's smooth everything out. Let's use the 4B pencil to dark even more that area. Next, we use the blending stamp again. Using the same 4B pencil, we'll create a dark detail around here. And create a transition with the pencil and smooth this transition with the blending stamp. And once we've created all the dark details, all the dark layers, we're going to use the pen eraser to create all the lightest details. Starting off with the opposite side from the first dark layer that you created on the beginning of the video. To make it more realistic, let's blend a little bit more and make it smoother. And back with the pen eraser, let's create all the brightest areas that we have on that crystal ball. The highlights is what is going to create the crystal effect. So you have to draw this on the right place and mainly so bright and white. Some reflections are not so bright, for example this one that I'm doing now. The idea here is, the crystal ball are reflecting all the environment. When it reflects light, this should be really white. But when it comes to reflection of white things or white objects around the environment, this is not going to be so white. So just like we did on the darkest areas, creating black and mid-tones, we're going to do the same thing with the brightest areas of the crystal ball. If you got a really bright detail and you want to make it darker, you can use a tissue to blend the area and make it dark. Alright, the crystal is done, and now let's create the shadow on the button. We'll start with the sketch, and then we'll start creating the hues using the same 4B pencil that we used the whole process. To create the shadow, you can go in circular motions or even linear motion. The main point is to create a really consistent shadow. Alright, once we've got in the darker area, we're going to make a transition between that dark area going over to the lightest area of the paper, going down. On the opposite side of where the light is coming from. After this, you can use the tissue to blend all this area. Let's make the shadow darker near to the ball and blend the graphite again, this time using the blending stamp. To finish, let's create some bright details projected on the surface where the crystal ball is. Create a transition in some areas of the light for not to have a really harsh cutoff point. This was the last details and it's ready. If you enjoyed, please give this video a like, leave your comment below and share to your friends. See you in the next video. Bye guys.